Get ready to match the stars. Gary Berghoff, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Adrienne Barbeau, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, John. What do you think of that? One is bloodshot.
No.
No. Oh, all right.
Winking. But the one that's winking is cutting off the circulation.
We welcome you, all of you gifted, beautiful people. Are you ready to have a go at it?
Oh, yes.
Shall we begin? Okay, let's say hello to Dale Geary and Doris Brewer. How do you do? Now we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. And Doris, we'll begin with you. Please tell us where you're from and all that.
Okay, I grew up in a small town in Michigan called Ovid. I went to Michigan State, came out to California, where I've been a school teacher for a lot of years, in the Burbank schools and Cal State Hayward, Cal State LA. Then in 1970, I got my PhD, but the most important degree I got was an MRS in 1972 when I became Mrs. Bob Brewer.
Oh, how nice. Isn't that sweet?
What do you teach? I'm going to start a new job right now in a college in Pasadena. I'll be teaching broadcast production.
Oh, good for you, Doris. Okay, we welcome you. Wish you the best of luck. Thank now you. Let's find out about Dale Geary.
I'm from Clinton.
You're Dale Geary. Now remember that.
That's right.
First thing you remember, when I say Dale Geary, bing, you're on. Go.
All right. I'm originally from Clinton, Tennessee. I now live in Upland, California. I'm married and have two daughters, Sherry 2 and Stacy 11.
Okay. All right, Dale, we welcome you. Wish you the best of luck. I point out to both of you that you're going to be trying to match as many celebrities as you can, and the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. I'll push the button, reveal our first round questions, and ask Doris to make a selection.
B for Brewer.
B for Brewer it is. Here we go. Shirley said, I am not going back to that psychiatrist anymore.
I'm with Shirley.
This morning, when I walked into his office, I saw his blank hanging from the coat rack.
That's why I'm not going back.
Yeah, that's why. I'm not going back anymore. This morning I walked to the office, saw his blank hanging from the coat rack. Okay.
Poor Shirley.
What did you say, Tommy?
I'll never tell. My answer's in my slot.
Easy.
Would you read it again?
All right.
Well, we'll read it again anyway.
Yes. Shirley said, I'm not going back to that psychiatrist anymore. This morning when I walked into his office, I saw his blank hanging from the coat rack.
Yeah.
It's all there is to it.
Are you sure it isn't, I'm not going back to that psychiatrist anymore this morning?
No. Anymore, period.
Oh.
Okay. Ready?
Wait a minute.
No. Oh, just put it in the slot.
All right.
And away we go. Oh, Charles has changed his mind.
What mind?
That's never mind.
Now, here we go. Doris, Shirley said, I am not going back to that psychiatrist anymore. This morning, when I walked into his office, I saw his blank hanging from the coat rack.
This is dumb, but I'll say his psychology books.
His books?
That's dumb, yeah.
Yeah. Altogether, dumb.
Dumb.
Dumb. But that's enough.
Yeah.
Trying a higher key next time. All right, Gary.
Not quite as dumb as mine, fella.
Oh, really? He's got a dumber one, Doris.
Oh, yeah.
Feel good.
Well, I figured that she had to be perhaps a little off balance to be going to a psychiatrist, which isn't necessarily true in real life, folks. You know, just a cliche. So I said.
Oh, that's the worst answer you've ever given on
this
show.
Well, all right, then I'll write another one.
No. Come on, let's see it.
I said his coat.
His coat. His coat was hanging from the coat rack.
Right.
I'd like to point out to you that he works steadily on MASH, and he doesn't need us, so be nice to him.
There. Why does he bother us then?
What do you say, Brett?
You know, my psychiatrist is very thin.
Oh, really? How thin is your psychiatrist?
My psychiatrist is so thin, if he shuts one eye...
could pass for.
Come on now.
Wait a minute. Here's the place right here. My psychiatrist is so thin, if he shuts one eye, he pass.
Yeah. Come on now.
Really,
does anybody else know the does anybody else know the jokes so we can get the punchline?
What is,
he's so thin he could pass
for a needle.
A needle.
Don't you get it? If you show,
will you show us your answer and stop that nonsense?
I love that so much. I just made it.
Give me that answer.
Wife.
I tell
who
you what a fella has to put up with. Charles. The question is
what you have to put up with.
Yeah.
You're 20 feet away, usually. This chair is nailed down.
Shirley said, I'm not going back to that psychiatrist anymore. This morning when I walked in his office, I saw his blank hanging from the coat
and
rack.
An L. Crummy answer, but so was hers. His couch.
His couch. Give us a good answer, Adrian.
I have the right answer.
Go.
Because I went to a psychiatrist.
Yes.
And I saw his trousers hanging from the coat rack. Oh. They were. I didn't go back.
There's no need for smut.
And now you know why I'm so messed up.
That's right. No, you look like the normal all-American girl to me. What do you say?
I say anyone who goes to a psychiatrist should have his head examined. I said the clothes were hanging,
From the coat rack.
El Nudo.
I walked in his office, saw his blank hanging from the coat rack, and she said, psychology books.
I think this will be excellent. I just have a feeling.
Yes.
But my mind does not run to clothes. I said it's teddy bear.
Teddy bear. Weirdo.
Hey. The cigar book.
Nobody matched anybody.
No.
There were no two answers.
Well, yeah, we were.
Does this mean,
oh, that's right. Yeah.
Does this mean I don't have to dance with her?
Yes.
Can I tell that joke again?
No. Once a millennium is enough.
I think she sniffs Babbo.
Call it.
Listen.
What? Hey, listen, you may not know this, but Gary Berghoff raises earthworms. I've been out to his house and I've seen him. He does this in his spare time to feed his fish. Anyway, Gary's wife said Gary has gotten too involved with this hobby. Every night before he comes to bed, Gary blanks his worms.
He said, what did Janet say?
Janet said Gary has gotten too involved with his hobby.
Too involved, yes.
Every night before he comes to bed, Gary blanks his worms.
Oh, golly gee whizzikers, crime.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the end of Brett's story.
There's nothing unusual.
No, I don't. Don't do that to me. I'll give you a punch right in the eye.
It was about this needle.
Now, you sure you don't want to hear that again?
Needle opened his eye and looked like a psychiatrist or something. I didn't understand.
Dale, are you ready?
He was very
thin. Gary Berghoff raises earthworms. He has a big trout pond, and so he has to feed the trout, so he has earthworms. He does this in his spare time. His wife, Janet, said, you know, Gary's gotten too involved with this hobby. Every night before he comes to bed, Gary blanks his worms.
Kisses
his worms. Yeah! Is this true, Gary? Are you a worm kisser?
I resent the way you are looking at me, sir. There is nothing unusual about that. Kisses and tucks in.
Kisses and tucks in as well. Okay, Dale. That's one for you. What do you say?
Gary's lost a lot of weight.
Come on.
And he's very thin.
Show me that cut. Her answer is hugs and kisses. That's another match. And tear it up and throw it away. Oh, Charles, I really feel for you, having to sit up there next to the wild...
I went another route.
What did you say?
I heard a different drum. It's a cute answer if you think about it. Counts his worms.
He counts his worms.
Like, was that like your end, or is that the other end?
Oh, I see. All right.
You count your blessings. See,
what
folks? Let's give Charles
daughter of Maud say?
I'm with you.
Tucks in and kisses them goodnight. Okay, that's me, Dale. Every night before he goes to bed, Gary kisses his worms. What do you say to that?
These worms had lost so much weight.
Are Are they thin?
I don't want to get involved. He kisses them night.
Okay. All right, Fanny.
Yeah.
Worm kissing. That's what we're into.
The psychiatrist had only one eye. Oh, kisses.
Kisses. All right, so the score is 5-0 in favor of Dale at the end of round one. Round two is coming up in a little bit, but right now this is coming your way.
Weekdays starting at noon, Buzzer is the place to play with our most popular shows. That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Weekdays starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Do you speak?
Yeah, shall we carry on here now? Okay, now let's see. Doris went first last time. You're ahead, Dale, so you go first this time.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go.
This is just for Charles.
Charles, you're the only one.
Oh, no.
It's only for you,
Charles. Charles is the dummy.
Listen, Charles.
This window is closed, so we open at 9 in the morning.
Oh, all right. Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
When the girls invited her to a shower, Dumb Dora showed up with a blank. Now that's easy, Charles.
Now that's as easy as you.
Okay, he's finished. That's one possibility. There are a number of other possibilities. But that's, he made his decision, and we come over here to Dale Yeary. Dumb Dora was so dumb, when the girls invited her to a shower, Dumb Dora showed up with a...
towel.
Towel. Charles, stand up and be counted.
I said cap.
Shower cap. Now, wait a minute.
Helen.
Hold, now, wait a
minute. Ma charuya.
He wears a shower cap every morning when he takes his shower, don't you, Charles?
I have to.
Yes.
With his wig.
Okay, so Dale, you've got 5. Now let's see. Doris, you've got to match 5 to stay in the game. If you match everybody, Doris, you could win the game.
Yeah.
Now listen to this. Brenda said,
Okay.
I've never been so shocked in my entire life. Yesterday, my living bra blanked me.
Don't look at me.
Well. Okay. Everybody finished?
No.
I've never been so shocked in my entire life. Yesterday, my living bra blanked me. Lights out up here.
Are you sure we have...
Yeah.
My living bra...
blanked me.
Why are they so quick? It makes us appear slow.
Yes, it does, doesn't it?
They have their cards written before you read
No. All right, Charles, put in the slot. Here we go. Doris. Brenda said, I've never been so shocked in my entire life. Yesterday, my living bra blanked me. May I help you, madam?
My living bra...
Living bra blanked me.
Squeezed me or squashed... Squeezed me.
Squeezed me. Mm-hmm. Okay. Good. I don't know. We'll find out. She said squeezed. What'd you say?
Well, I said, you can squeeze between two fingers and you call it a pinch.
Is that a match? Yeah, okay.
I can't squeeze everyone between two fingers.
The Italian in me that made me say
Adrian says you can't squeeze everyone between two fingers.
There's somebody on this panel you couldn't squeeze between two fingers.
I know that.
That's the guy with the one eye.
Show.
I said bit, which I think is a match.
Bit. No, bit is not squeezed. A bit is a good answer. All right, now you got to match everybody else to stay in the game, Doris, and it's up to you, Charles.
I said bit too, I'm
bit.
Sorry.
So that means Dale wins the game.
Make 5.
Congratulations. Stand by for a moment here. Now, Doris, we're going to have to say goodbye to you. I wish you the very best of luck in your new teaching career. And we have a gift for you, together with our thanks for being here with us on Match Game PM. Doris Brewer.
Bye, Doris.
Okay, Dale. How do you feel?
Nervous.
You feel nervous? You know, he doesn't look nervous, does he?
No.
Not much.
No.
He looks thin to me.
Dale.
What are you waiting, Dave?
About? We're all
here, friendly people here.
He might win and have to kiss you.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
Well, I never thought.
Now, we're going to do a little commercial message here, Dale. And then we're going to come back and see how you do with the big money super match where you can win over $10,000. Come right back.
It's ring.
Here we are with Dale Yeary. You ready, Dale?
Yes.
It's time now for the Big Money Super Match, or you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we've got two audience matches for you here. And whatever you win here, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Here we go. Here comes the first one. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Master, or Blank Master. Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you collect $250, and if you match the bottom one, you get $100. Now, three of the celebrities, remember, are permitted to help, and it's time for you to call on them one at a time now.
Richard.
Headmaster.
Headmaster. All right, there's one.
Gary.
All I can think of is Bandmaster.
Bandmaster. You got two now.
Charles.
What is two? You're Taskmaster.
Taskmaster. So those are the three. Taskmaster.
Thank you so much for your support.
Bandmaster.
We'll be open again in tomorrow.
And Headmaster. Do you want one of those? Or have you had any ideas, Dale?
I'll take Richards.
You take Richards. Okay, that was Headmaster. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it is there, where is it? That is the question. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Schoolmaster. All right, looking for Headmaster. Here's the $250 response. Dutch Master.
What on earth does that mean? Now, who did they have in here that day?
A bunch of artists. A bunch of cigar smokers, yes.
Oh,
all right, last chance for Headmaster. Here's the $500 response. Scoutmaster.
Oh, no.
Scoutmaster, and no one thought of that.
There's also Mixmaster.
There's Mixmaster,
and
too.
And Toastmaster.
There's also...
Yes.
Cakemaster.
Listen, I'm
Johnson
sure you didn't win anything, Dale, but you still have another chance, and we're going to do another audience match right now. Are you ready, Earl? I tell you, Earl, if you're ready, knock twice. He's ready. Now, we polled another audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank a leg.
I got it. I got it.
Okay, who do you want?
Richard.
Shake a leg.
Shake a leg. Okay.
Charles, what did Richard say?
He said shake a leg.
Shake a leg?
Shake a leg, that means hurry
up. Or break a leg.
Break a leg.
That means slow down.
Fanny.
Fanny, have you got one?
Arm and up.
Arm and a leg.
Arm and up.
Arm and a leg. It costs
an arm and a leg.
An arm and a leg.
Just pay for
Isn't she a quick thinker, though? So you got arm and a leg, break a leg, and shake a leg. You want one of those, Dale, or do you want give us one of your own?
Fanny, arm and a leg.
Arm and a leg. Okay, that's what he wants. It's up to him. Arm and a leg is what he says. Here we go now. Let's find out what's under the $100 response. Pull a leg. Okay. Anything you say, dear.
I have.
Let's see if $250 reveals arm and a leg. Shake a leg.
Oh, you may be right, you little devil.
He may be. Last chance for arm and a leg. Here is the $500 number.
Oh!
Well, that's the first time we've ever done that.
Well, he had it. I said it.
This has never happened before.
That audience was made up of cigar-smoking actors.
Well, no, those break a leg is really a perfectly logical answer.
Well, and shake a leg.
Break a leg is a total show business.
But he didn't choose any of those. He chose the one that the little weirdo on the end gave him there. Arm and a leg there. Gee, I'm sorry, Dale, but Dawson's a good kisser. He'll give you a consolation kiss afterwards. What's that? Oh, you got the $100. That's his irrevocably, and we got gifts and all that.
But with the way your luck's going, Dale, you'll probably be mugged on the way home.
All right, we'll come back right after this message. Here we go.
Next, Match Game's funny blank-filling stars help players laugh all the way to the bank. Then on the Newlywed Game, couples fill blanks and may end up in the doghouse. Stay tuned.
America.
Here I am, all alone. Dale Yeary deserted me. He took his $100 and he vamoosed.
And we had expected him to try for the $10,000. It's the first time this has ever happened. And so we've got a little time to talk about something. Listen.
Yeah.
I saw you read a letter once on the...
Merv show.
On the Merv Griffin show, yes. Have you got it there? Yeah. Listen, now you get, this is going to be fascinating.
This is honestly a real letter, and it was written by a bricklayer to the firm for whom he worked, and it went like this. Respected sirs, when I got to the top of the building, I noticed the hurricane had knocked some bricks off of the top. So I rigged up a beam with a pulley at the top of the building and hoisted up a couple of barrelfuls of bricks. When I had fixed the building, there were a lot of bricks left over. I hoisted the barrel back up again and secured the line at the bottom. Then I went up and filled the barrel with extra bricks. Then I went to the bottom and cast off the line. Unfortunately, the barrel of bricks was heavier than I was. And before I knew what was happening, the barrel had started down, jerking me off of the ground. I decided to hang on. Halfway up, I met the barrel coming down and received a severe blow on the shoulder. I then continued to the top, banging me head against the beam and getting my fingers jammed in the pulley. When the barrel hit the ground, it burst at the bottom, allowing all of the bricks to spill out. I was now heavier than the barrel. So I started down again at high speed. Halfway down, I met the barrel coming up and received severe injuries to my shin. When I hit the ground, I landed on the bricks, getting several painful cuts from the sharp edges. At this point, I must have lost my presence of mind, because I let go of the line. The barrel then came down, giving me another heavy blow, rendering me unconscious. I respectfully request sick leave.
Richard, marvelous. Join us next time for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive a Cardinal heating system. Turn your fireplace into a mini furnace with a Cardinal Firebird heating system. Save fuel by doubling fireplace heat output. Firebird from Cardinal. And buy a pair of Haggar double-knit slacks in temporary styling with a comfortable fit. They're machine washable in a wide range of beautiful colors and patterns. Haggar double-knit slacks. A new pulsating water massage from Polynex, featuring four shower heads in one, lets you dial how you want to feel. Installs easily. And a gift supply of Capri's new bath oil buds. Fragrant oils captured in tiny buds that blossom to smooth and soften your skin. And for a smooth running car, Castrol DVX motor oil for all models and sizes of cars. Castrol lubrication for cars, motorcycles, and snowmobiles. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.